Hey everyone, DJ Chance here. I'm here to show you the Denon Envoi battery powered speaker and how you can do a really small outside party. So I'm 160 feet away, and that's not counting the space in between. And we've got a train going by. So that's what makes us lose the sound. And it's supposed to be only 80 watts, and that's the most powerful 80 watts I think I've ever heard. Isn't that amazing? Without any power cords at all, maybe you want to do an event out in the woods, someone's backyard, maybe you have to DJ or provide music on a beach. You can do that here without worrying about electricity. The Denon Envoi comes with a few surprises. It comes with this bag, as you can see, and the bag has a little trick up its sleeve as well. It unzips here, so this way you can cover the handle. And it's also got a hidden compartment because this comes with two wireless microphones. So you press that open, and there's your antenna for the back of the speaker, and you have two wireless mics. Now we're going to test those out, and you'll see that they have pretty short range. They're okay microphones, but I would suggest you bring a different mic if you really want something that's going to project your voice well and stand up to the scrutiny of wind noise when you're outside. You can see it's got this retractable luggage type of handle, and it has wheels on the back of it for portability. So you can just grab this like any piece of luggage and just start moving it and drag this right along to your gig. Also, you get an optional microphone that you can buy that's a lav. So if you're giving this to a priest or someone who's going to do a ceremony at a wedding, you can clip this right on. It's battery powered and it's wireless, and you'll be able to pick it up right on the back of the speaker. As you can see on the rear of the Denon Envoi, there's an entire suite of inputs, and its powered amplifier is all in this one back panel. You can see it's got a section for your wireless microphones here with its own separate volume. You've got the MP3 player USB right here, so you can plug in little flash drives, or you can plug in a phone or a tablet if you don't have Bluetooth. And this also has Bluetooth. It has an SD card input as well. I don't know anyone that's actually going to use an SD. Most people tend to have a little flash drive. So you've got all your controls here for the MP3 player, and there's various settings in here that you can adjust as well. And right here it just tells you 34 minutes on there. There's your play. It's telling you what's playing. It's telling you it's a normal mode, and it's a USB, and it's telling you the title of the song. It also gives you a little bar graph to show you the music playing. On the other parts, you see the volume control for the Bluetooth section, and underneath that, you see the auxiliary and RCA inputs for channel 1. Now, this is a 35 millimeter or 1/8 stereo plug, and of course, RCA, and you have your two mic channels or line inputs. You can switch them. They've got little switches here you can depress and switch over from line to microphone. And you've got quarter inch TRS and XLR inputs with their own separate volumes. And you have an equalizer for the speaker itself for all of the outputs that you've plugged into this. And you've got your master out here, and you get a little bit of a reverb for your microphone. And that's a nice little effect. You've also got your line out here, so if you've got another powered speaker, you can run it one to another in case you only have one output from your mixer or whatever it is you have plugged into this. You also have a switch for the MP3 and auxiliary, so you can switch back and forth. Now the MP3 is going to be whatever's plugged into the USB port here, where it says MP3 player. I'm going to depress this switch and we'll start to hear music coming off of the USB. You've got all your controls here. You can stop the song, you can press play, and you can loop the song, you can skip through tracks, and you'll get all the information. You get the turn of the Mac right there. So I'm going to show you different modes that you can achieve with this back panel here. So you see now it's in the connecting mode because that's looking for a Bluetooth signal. You hit the mode again, you see it's waiting, it's going to go right back to whatever song was playing in the exact spot the song stopped. We're going to stop that there. The modes here, because you've got EQ modes and play modes, and you've got different presets here. So in order to get into the EQ mode, you're going to have to depress the mode button for about a second, and you're going to get the EQ and the play modes and changing of your device menu. And you scroll through them with the forward and backwards buttons. So you're going to change your device, you have your exit. You want your EQ, in order to enter, you're gonna have to press the play button. You press the play button, and there you have your different EQs. You've got normal, pop, rock, jazz, classic, country, and low bass. Setting up the antenna is really easy. You've got these little tabs here in order to cover them. But what you do is you remove the little tab, and then you just screw on the antenna. Just twist it around, and it'll mount. And it's adjustable in all different ways. So now it's on here, you can put it nice and tight. And then adjust this as you need it. The other modes that this has is this also has separate modes other than EQ. You hold the mode button in like you did before, and you've got the play mode and change device. Now use this to scroll, and you can go through change device, your exit, your play mode. That's going to give you the modes of what you're going to play, how you're going to play these files. So you press that in, and you've got normal, you've got it playing random songs. It'll browse through your folder, and again, you can press play and you can browse yourself. You can repeat everything on here. You can repeat the one song, or you can repeat a specific folder. So it gives you some options there, and then normal is what I generally have it on. It'll just go from song to song. But if you want to change it, you have the ability to. So we're going to put that back on normal.
So if you could see, I'm about 100 feet away, as witnessed by all of these 10-foot doors with the storage.
That little splotch you see all the way back there, that's the Denon Envoi. And from this range, the lavalier mic still works well. Place it on your priest or whoever.
Here I am, about 25 feet from the speaker. Here's one mic, here's the other mic.
They don't sound all that good, very staticky.
Even as I get closer, the approach just gets worse. It could be the building, but I've had this experience before.
See this one?
Hello there. See, now it sounds good. The distortion went away, but I moved back about 10 feet, and as you can hear, it cuts off quite a bit. Second microphone. I'm now about 30 feet away, and you can hear it cuts out. So you've got to be fairly close with these microphones. You've got to be in a very clear area. Too much RF interference as I get closer. A little more. These mics aren't that good. If you're going to use this thing, you use it with the lavalier.
I'd say I'm about 40 feet.
See, it cuts in and out. It's just not good beyond like 25 feet. But again, you're getting two wireless microphones for such a cheap price, $6.99. Now, I'm pretty far away in the other direction. Now, I put it, you got two locker doors, 3, 4, 5. So I'm about 40 to 50 feet away. You can hear me clearly, but you do have some RF interference, and it could be due to the power lines as well. So here I am testing the second microphone, and we're getting the same kind of results. You can see as I back up, it just kind of cuts out, but I am fairly far away.
One of the drawbacks is the mics that come with this aren't good, so I would suggest if you want to speak, buy the optional HL. Number for this is the Envoi HL transmitter, and it has various settings that you can get to on here. You've got the input, of course. You've got the mic DB, the little pad there for 0 decibels or 10 decibels, and you've got the standby mode on and off, so you can keep it in standby once you put it on whoever's doing a service or whoever's speaking, and then just switch it on and then you're good to go. Charging the speaker takes about 10 hours, and you can use any IEC plug that you have on a computer, or pretty much anything. This is the standard kind of plug you see. So get 10 hours of good charge time, and you can get 12 hours out of it if you have it halfway. I usually use it about 4 to 5 hours at some gigs, but many gigs, since I use this for the ceremony, this doesn't get used all that often. I've only used it once or twice for an actual gig in a backyard and something I did out in the woods for a wedding. And I actually had to uplight. I don't have the uplights with me. I don't know why I'm pointing, but I have my battery powered uplights as well. I lit up the trees and it was really nice. And I have to do a video about that as well. I think I'm going to do that. It's just too cold right now. So here you've got your 10-inch driver and your high frequency horn here. The power of this thing is 120 watts on AC power, and it's 80 watts on the battery charge, and 160 max.
Feeling so strong. I know you've been treating yourself wrong. So let me care for you, ooh, baby.
as you heard, 80 watts travels really far with this thing. Now the spec sheet on here says that it's about 66 feet of range with the wireless microphones, and you saw we were about that far away. So that's the drawback with this particular speaker, is that the wireless mics it comes with are really cheap microphones. They don't weigh all that much either. They weigh like your basic kind of karaoke mic. That's what this would be good for. You're not getting a real expensive microphone, as witnessed by the price. For $6.99, you're not getting two wireless UHF mics that are really high quality. Pretty much what you're paying for is the Denon quality and the brand name. Me personally, I would buy the HL lavalier microphone. I know it's optional and I believe it was $80, but that's the route I went. With the lavalier microphone as well, you can walk with this thing and talk. So if you're doing like a tour of a place, you can just put this handle up, put the battery on, and just talk with your lavalier mic and the speaker aimed at your audience behind you. So here's how you get into DJing in a portable fashion. Just get your laptop, get a little Numark DJ to go to touch, or whatever little controller you have, plug that in, output master into that little speaker, and you don't have to worry about any power cables here, and do a nice little gig without running extension cords. Let's take a listen. I'm gonna play a track, and it's of course gonna be one of my own little remixes here. And I'm gonna walk way out there and see how far we can get some good sound. I can keep going further too. I gotta be 100 plus feet now. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So I'm 160 feet away, and that's not counting the space in between. And we've got a train going by. So that's what makes us lose the sound. Words of the beginning of this particular verse are fitting, because I have to go all the way back there since we had the train interrupt me. You'll see what I mean in a second. And I'm about 40 feet away. Your crowd is never going to be farther than this. So your dance floor area is covered nicely. A steady 87 decibels going as far as I was, and like I said, I was about 60-70 feet away when I took that measurement. So frequently get asked about this stand when I'm somewhere. It's just a normal kind of music stand. It's just a small Samson, the LTS50, and this is the maximum height it goes, and it's about up to my stomach here. You know, it's a good height, so you can see where I am. And it's got this little attachment here. You've got this shelf here you can attach to it, and it's adjustable. It's just like a normal music stand. But this comes in very handy for these types of gigs. And even putting the microphones on here, so that way whoever needs to announce something, the microphones can stay here while I'm playing music, or if this is in a separate room, I can leave everything pretty much on top of here. I put a little thing on the sides here to hold it in place so the mics don't roll off. But this thing's handy. This is a nice little setup. Other things of note for the microphones, you've got the frequency on here because that may be important to some people. There's also a gain control here. So if you're not loud enough, you can switch that and turn it. Also, let me take this off here. At the bottom, you have the high and low impedance switch. So you can switch that right here on the transmitter itself. And that's a good little touch to have. Now the back of this thing also has a mute level. What that mute level is actually for is if you're getting too much RF interference and you see this light really going crazy, you kind of adjust that counterclockwise or clockwise until you get, you kind of adjust that counterclockwise. That way you can adjust what kind of RF interference you're actually getting. You could also change the channels for the microphones. Now this has up to 16 channels. In order to change the channel, it's attach it to a specific microphone, all you have to do is turn the microphone on and place the IR sensor that you see right here above the batteries. This takes AA batteries, by the way. You put the IR sensor right there next to the IR sensor on the speaker, and you press the ASC button, and you just hold it for a couple seconds until the LED will stop flashing, and then it'll find an interference-free channel, and the wireless mic will be matched to that channel. When you're done with your gig, everything goes right inside the speaker, so that's handy. I've got my body pack for the lavalier mic, little USB in order to have music. It's always good to have a backup, and you put your other two mics in there, and you're pretty much done with your gig. You close that, and you're ready to go. Just pop the cover on here.
There you have it. Everything in this video is sitting right there. Got three pieces there to walk in with. Speaker in one hand, you throw this laptop bag over your shoulder, and I have the controller in there in its own case. I have the plate for the top of this in that bag, all my wires, and then that stand. Throw this on your shoulder, grab this and wheel it away, put that in your other hand, and you've got yourself a nice little gig. In and out, it'll take you 5 minutes to set up, 5 minutes to tear down, and you really can't beat that for only carrying about 60 pounds of stuff.
That's my review. So if you like it, please hit the like and subscribe and share with a friend. And don't forget to ring that bell. Just punch that bell so you'll be notified every time I put a new video up every week. And that's it, everyone. DJ Chance, now master and make money.